All right, when we deal with recursive rules, the only difference between a recursive rule and the rules that we've already learned, which are called explicit rules, is what we are addressing. Explicit rules, like we said, always start at our first term, and they tell us how to get to any term from there. But our marker is that first term, okay? The difference when we ask for a recursive rule means that when we have a sequence, we are not necessarily starting at the beginning and telling you how to get to the end. It relates two, maybe three, sometimes even four. It relates from one term to the next. It tells you how to go from a term before to get to the next term. And so it might be these two terms, how to get from four to five. Now, sometimes they are consistent across the board, but what recursive rules allow us to do is recursive rules allow us to have more complicated sequences where it's not simply adding a single common difference or multiplying by a single common ratio. It might be taking where you were at and then doing something specific, or it might be taking maybe two terms and adding those together to get a third term. So recursive rules give us an opportunity to have more complicated sequences along the way. But they, instead of starting at the first term, recursive rules address a section, each section. How do I get from this one to the next? Okay. Recursive rules also address the term factorial. You'll start seeing that, and we're going to use that in the next chapter as well. Factorial simply means that we start at one number and we multiply times every counting number all the way down. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. And to do that, that's specifically for factorials. With a recursive rule, recursive rules have, they always require at least two equations that they're going to give you. They've got to give you information on the front end. They have to tell you where to start, and then they have to tell you how to get the next one. Right. So when you write out a recursive rule, you're always going to write, where are you starting? If we don't know where we're starting, we cannot have a recursive rule. So where do we start and how do we get to the next one? So we see we've got a little bit more complicated equation over here. So we're going to start at one, and then it's a matter of plugging in. So to get to the second one, we would plug in two for this n value. So we'd have 2 times a sub 2 minus 1. That means a sub 1. So I have to go back. So if I started at 0 to get to the first one, I've got to find my first one. 1 times 1 minus 1 is 0. So this is where we took what we already knew and we plugged it in to get the next value. Now, a sub 0 means nothing to us anymore. We've now, to get to 2, we've got to use what we just found in 1. So we'd have 2 times a sub 1. So I've got 2 times 1 gives me 2. Then now a sub 2 has nothing to do with it anymore. So to get 3, or sorry, a sub 1 doesn't have anything. So to get to 3, I need 3 times a sub 2. So we're using the answer that we found to find the next one. And if you were to look at this, there's not a geometric sequence with a simple common R value. And there's not a simple common difference to find these. However, this is still a sequence. It's just a different type of sequence. It's not an arithmetic sequence. It's not a geometric sequence. It's a recursive sequence. It depends upon the value that you get before to get to the next one. Okay. So Fibonacci sequence are the most famous ones. They're found all over. They're found in nature. God had a sense of humor on that one, and it's lots of places when you look around. So Fibonacci sequence actually starts out with two terms. You have to know the first term and the second term. And the third term is the addition of the two previous terms. So as we would find a sub 3, we would find out that it's the first term plus the second term, which is why they had to give us 2 in the first place. So we'd have 1 plus 1 gives us 2. So now for 4, we're going to need 2. We add 2 and 3 to get 4. For 5, we're going to add 3 and 4 to get 5. And hopefully, as you follow along on the notes, you can see where we're just plugging in our different values that we have found. They're just getting replaced back in. So we have 1 and 2, 1 and 2. Now we have 2 and 3, 2 and 3, 3 and 5, 3 and 5. So the next one would be 5 and 8 would get multiplied to get the next term. And we would have 13 for our next term. And then 8 plus 13 would give us the next term. So we're going to have 21 there. And you would continue jumping along. I kind of like to think about recursive sequences, kind of like leapfrog, where we're just going from one to the next. Okay. I've got a couple of examples on there. I've got some notes that talk about the difference between our explicit rules and our recursive rules. So if we have the exact same sequence, our explicit rule is going to start with our first term and tell us how much we're jumping by. And we would be able to write our explicit term in terms of any value. Whoops. If we were going to look at our recursive rule relates one term to the next. And so we would relate, say, a sub 2 to a sub 1. Or we would relate a sub 4 to a sub 3. We're going to write it with two different terms that are related to each other. Okay. Got a couple of different examples for that. So on the test, you just need to know how to solve a recursive rule, what it means whenever you are given a value and then you are given the recursive rule. How do you find the next terms? Sorry, Jace, I misspoke on that. For the test, you will actually need to also know how to write a recursive rule. So I'm going to go over that if my phone doesn't die here. So there are a couple of different examples here on the notes if you want to go back and pull up the notes for it. But remember that our explicit rule, these are our equations that we were given, you know, in 11.1 and 11.3 when we were dealing with arithmetic and geometric sequences. Those are going to be your explicit rules. To write a recursive rule, you need to have the actual term values, and you're going to look at it and say, how does one term relate to the next one? So in this case, I would call this A1, A2, A3, A4. Okay. These, when we write out our recursive rules, are written in a generic n value, right? So if I'm finding any term, the term before it, let's look at it this way. If I call this term n, anything before it is going to be n minus 1, and anything after it would be n plus 1, correct? So if I start at one place, if I went before it, I would subtract. If I go ahead, I'm going to add, right? So if I am looking between 4 and 7, how do I get from 4 to 7? I would say that to find 7, so because we're starting with what we're wanting to find, we're always wanting to find this next one. So to find 7, I have to start at 4. And so I wrote, to find a sub 2, I would have to start at a sub 1 and add 3 to it. I could also say, let's address these two together, the 13. To find a sub 4, I need to start at a sub 3 and I need to add 3 to it. Okay, but we can't write 4 and 3. We have to write it generically because we need to be able to solve for any of those. So what do 2 and 1 have in common? And what do 4 and 3 have in common? Well, if 4 was my n value, then 3 is my n minus 1 value. So we're going to make our left side be a sub n. And then that helps us figure out what is our right side. How do I relate my subscript to the subscript that I already have? If I call 4 in, how would I find 3? I would need to take 4 minus 1 to get myself to a 3. So to relate 4 to 7, or to relate 7 to 10, or 10 to 13, I would do a sub n would equal the term beforehand plus 3 is what we're telling us. So what would be our next one? I would say a sub 5 would equal a sub 4, because that's 5 minus 1 is 4, plus 3. So a sub 4 is 13. 13 plus 3 gives me 16. Does 16 make sense if I plug that in there? 4, 7, 10, 13, 16. Yes, 16 makes sense. So a sub 5 is equal to 16. So writing a recursive rule, it must be written with an a sub n, which means that we're going to talk about the term before it, which will be an n minus 1 somewhere in there. And then you're going to tell, how do I get from the term before to the next term?